Coming up on Tribe Update, we're talking to representatives from both sides of the Living Wage campaign. You'll have a behind-the-scenes look of the new Cohen Career Center. There's also a new place in CW where students can relax and enjoy a cold treat. And we had the chance to speak with an alum who had her own homecoming of sorts. That's coming up now on Tribe Update. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Tribe Update. I'm Lauren Stevenson. Well, fall has arrived, and with it have come changes here at the William & Mary campus. To begin, Elizabeth Pelletier gives us the latest details on the living wage movement, which has sparked conversation among the William & Mary community.
In recent weeks, the topic of workers' compensation has generated much discussion throughout the William & Mary community. Members of the Tidewater Labor Support Committee, along with other William & Mary students, faculty, and staff, formed a living wage coalition in order to petition the administration. The campaign has used a variety of strategies to persuade the administration to increase wages and change its treatment of workers, specifically housekeeping staff. The coalition has held forums for workers to speak out, organized a march to President Taylor Reeves' house, and most recently petitioned the president. Maggie Russolello, a student member of the Living Wage campaign, says housekeeping staff came to the committee with their concerns.
Wages have always been the underlying issue, but towards the beginning of the campaign, it was more of an issue with vacancies. I believe that there were about 7 vacancies, give or take.
Brian Whitson, the spokesperson for the college, says that the administration has been working to address the committee's concerns by meeting regularly with representatives of the housekeeping staff.
One of the example of some progress that we have seen is the hiring of temporary workers. That was an idea that came out of those meetings, and we agreed it made sense and moved on it immediately and filled those positions with temporary workers while we filled them with permanent workers as well.
Whitson says that 6 of the 7 vacancies have been filled. The Living Wage Coalition points to a living wage calculator developed by Penn State University, which, according to Russolello, suggests that William & Mary workers are being paid below living wages.
There are people who have been working here for 20 years who are still being paid under $11 an hour. And the living wage calculator from Penn State University has said that in order to support one adult and one child in Williamsburg, you need to be paid $18.49 an hour.
Whitson tells Tribe Update that William & Mary's average wage is higher than that of the state average. He says the pay range for custodial workers is between $18,720 and $25,715. Despite the current economic crisis, Whitson says Virginia state employees will receive a 3% bonus in the coming year, but he emphasizes the importance of creating a new financial model for the college.
You've probably heard the statistics that in 1980, the state provided 43% of our operating budget. Today, that's 14% and expected to drop to 12% next year. So as we move forward and we look at a new financial model, a big part of that is going to be to help our people.
The Living Wage Coalition recognizes the current economic crisis, but says that the college needs to increase workers' compensation.
This is a personal issue, and it's affecting these workers, and it's affecting our campus community, and it's a really important thing that everyone needs to get on board.
We will continue to monitor this story and bring you any new details as they come up. For Tribe Update, I'm Elizabeth Pelletier.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Well, on Wednesday, September 29th, the new Cohen Career Center opened its doors to the William & Mary community. Recently, I had the opportunity to tour the Career Center and speak with its director and associate director about their initiative to bring more freshmen and sophomores into the Cohen Career Center. It's beautiful, state-of-the-art, and a new addition to the William & Mary campus. The Sherman and Gloria H. Cohen Career Center opened its doors not long ago, and it has already proved to be a valuable addition to William & Mary's campus. According to Mary Schilling, the director of the Cohen Career Center, the $7.9 million building has already hosted on-campus interviews, corporate tailgate events, and business case competitions for students.
Recently, we had the ambassador who was formerly from Venezuela, and so we teleconferenced him in to talk about State Department jobs.
The building, located between Zabel Stadium and the Sadler Center, houses multiple on-campus interviewing rooms, has video conferencing capabilities, and a rooftop terrace, which has an unparalleled view of Zabel Stadium.
This is a brilliant thing on the part of the architects to both back the building up to the football stadium and then to accommodate a rooftop terrace. It will take about 172 people. Or kind of a stand-up reception.
In addition to this new building, the Cohen Career Center has also implemented new programming, specifically geared towards freshmen and sophomores. So basically what we want to try to do is make sure that first and second year students on campus realize that we're also here for them. And so we're trying to market programs and opportunities that are specifically for them, not just for the student body at large. In the coming weeks, we have a program about the internship process at the CIA. And even though the CIA is one of the most popular recruiters on campus for many students, we've limited that program just to freshmen and sophomores, and we've made it more of an educational focus.
Schilling hopes students will utilize the new Cohen Career Center.
This is for them. This is their building, and they can continue to use it as they are alumni.
The new Cohen Career Center is open from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. To make an appointment, call the number on your screen. Well, moving from the newest addition to William & Mary's campus to the newest addition to CW, Alexis Veracruz has the scoop on Berrybody, which has already become popular amongst William & Mary students.
The recent grand opening of Berrybody in CW has had William & Mary campus buzzing with excitement. Coupled with a new yoga studio, Berrybody has created a delicious and healthy spin on frozen desserts. The yogurt is low in calories, low in sugar, and is completely fat-free. Joy Tamburi-Pate, the owner of Berrybody, wants to promote healthy living.
We're living the lifestyle, we're preaching the lifestyle, we want you to be healthier, we want you to be fitter.
Berrybody has three flavors. Every day they have tart and green tea, and the third flavor changes.
We only choose flavors that have no high fructose corn syrup and no partially hydrogenated oils, so we're very particular about what flavors we have. It's all fat-free, it has all the probiotics and live and active cultures that's in actual yogurt.
Then your dessert is served with a choice of three toppings, which can include cereal, candy, or fruit. To try one of these new delicious healthy treats, visit their new location in Colonial Williamsburg, right down the street from the campus shop. For Tribe Update, I'm Alexis Veracruz.
Thanks, Alexis. Berrybody is delicious. Well, just a few weeks prior to homecoming, a William & Mary alum had her own homecoming of sorts on William & Mary's stage. Alana Wildermuth has this story and more about recent events here on campus.
October has been another great month full of awesome events. On October 15th, AMP brought to campus a free presentation of Baby Wants Candy, a hilarious improvisational musical that once included Jack McBrayer from 30 Rock and Seth Meyers and Rachel Dratch from Saturday Night Live. The highly entertaining show creates a 60-minute show based on an audience suggestion. Finley Park, the AMP Comedy Committee Chair, is glad he found this group at the NAFA conference.
To be honest, what I was most impressed by is that, they do an hour show based off of like three or two words that the entire audience just shouts, and that's 45 minutes of unscripted hilariousness.
This was not only a special night for our campus, it was also a homecoming for William & Mary alum Jenny Hagel, a member of the Baby Wants Candy improv group.
William & Mary totally prepared me for a career in improv, actually. First of all, it was the first place where I ever performed improv. I saw IT when I came for like a prospective students weekend and immediately fell in love with it, and that's actually why I went to William & Mary, just because I wanted to watch IT, not even thinking that I would like be in IT. But I was in it all 4 years that I was here, and so it was my first exposure to improv. So that was huge, and it prepared me in that way.
Later that night, the Richmond Road Residence Life staff put on a scavenger hunt with a theme based on the board game Clue. Teams of four searched throughout the campus to find the Richmond Road killer and figure out the crime for special prizes. The Fab Four group enjoy experiences like this on campus.
They sort of get the whole campus involved. They give us a sense of unity. It gives us something fun to do, something to get behind, something to get excited about.
Scavenger hunts are popular this month. The Raritan Club organized a scavenger hunt at Lake Metoka, and AMP Late Night promoted a photo scavenger hunt at the end of the month. For more information, go to our website at tribeupdate@wmtv.me. For Tribe Update, I'm Alana Bodemuth.
Thank you, Alana. That was a lot of fun. Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of Tribe Update. Don't forget to fan us on Facebook and email us at tribeupdate@wmtv.me with any story suggestions. I'm Lauren Stevenson. Thank you for watching. And until next time, for all of us here at William & Mary Television, go Tribe.